Planet Dolan. From what the biggest star ever is to where the rain has an actual smell, we answer some of your most burning questions about life.
Hey there! My name is Doopy, and I'll be reading out the questions and answers.
I'm Danger Dolan, and I'm here to blow your mind with truth.
PT12 asks, how do bees make their hives?
With hammer and nails. You think it's easy for them? They're like a millimeter wide. Tools are out of the question. You know that saying, you're being a busy bee? You think that's just idle talk? No, these things work 36-hour days. Considering the work they put in, hives are a goddamn biblical monument created by their whole tribe.
You're like deeply invested in this, aren't you?
I dig bees. I like their attitude.
Yeah, till they sting you with their butt and die.
Why would you say that?
Honeybees construct their hives by chewing on wax until it is soft enough to mold into the hexagonal cells that make up the hive. The worker bees store honey in their stomachs and turn it into wax using their glands. The hive is constructed in a location that is protected from weather, such as a hole in a tree. Why Steezer asks, why does rain have a smell?
Fast food. These companies pump in plumes of greasy gas from factories just so you can have your McObesity burger, killing the environment with waves of stinky oily air, melting the polar caps, ending the lives of children, all for a handful of your grime-ridden chicken strips.
No, that stuff's delicious. I'd kill for a box of the greasiest chicken wings, 30 nuggets with a tub of some chocolate mousse. Oh gosh, I need it.
You're part of the problem, Doopy.
No, go away. I love my grease. Rain has a smell because of a chemical reaction that's caused by the oil that plants secrete during dry periods. When the rain hits the ground after a dry spell, it releases the odor into the air through microscopic particles called aerosols. The pleasant smell of rain is called petrichor. Also, lightning can split oxygen and nitrogen molecules during a thunderstorm, creating nitric oxide. This scent is known as ozone.
Your scent is known as stink, fatty.
Dolan, stop!
Gotta stop eating that smelly fast food.
Never!
Freddy Fuzabar RO150 asks, can we still breathe without gravity?
Here's the thing though. If there's no gravity, that means you're likely in space, which means there's no air. It is difficult to breathe in space, I've heard.
But what about those rooms they put you in where you float and stuff?
That's not a real thing?
Yes it is. My dad knew a guy who did it.
Well, I know a guy who says you're wrong. Me. It's me. You're wrong.
Yes, you can breathe without gravity, but only if you have something to keep the air around you, either a spacesuit or spaceship. Gravity helps us breathe on Earth because it holds in the atmosphere, keeping the air around us. So, gravity is not necessary for breathing as long as there is another means of containing air. Escamillo Animations asks, who started naming plants with Latin names and why?
Someone who just hates making things easy for us. They couldn't just walk up to a brown leaf and say, yep, this is a brown leaf. No, instead it's a Brownlificus Momentum Shuggy Boogie Reputinous. Thanks. Man, you really cleared up that confusion, didn't ya?
Ha! Gotcha, Dolan!
What? What are you talking about? Where'd you come from?
That old thing you said a little while back? Calling my skin condition Verdificus Melissali? That's a Latin name. If you were so interested in avoiding confusion, why didn't you just call it bird disease?
Wow. Sure, you're right. I'm sorry for that thing I apparently did.
Thank you! Sorry to interrupt, Doopy. Just had to correct Dolan. Later, guys!
Yeah, you, really sorted me out.
It was a Swedish naturalist, Carl Linnaeus, who developed the binomial system for naming plants, which groups plants into genus and species. He chose Latin because it doesn't need to be translated and will always mean the same thing since it's a dead language and therefore won't change over time. Micromater asks, why do dinosaur fossils remain on Earth but human skeletons don't?
Because dinosaurs were huge, mate. Humans are puny, trippy things that die if you breathe on them wrong. If it takes 30 years for a human skeleton to waste away, trust me, it'll take 3 billion years for those old dinosaurs to clear out.
3 billion? Come on, that's a bit of an exaggeration, right?
Nah. When you die, I give your skeleton 3 years, tops.
Well, I guess I won't die then.
Good luck.
Dinosaur fossils aren't skeletons, but rocks that replace the bones after minerals leached from them while being encased in the earth after a disaster, usually volcanic eruption, that prevents the air from reaching the bones. Human fossils have been found, but skeletons don't remain on Earth because all organic matter will eventually decompose. Bones just do so at a slower rate. Lunar Star Girl AJ asks, why is glass fragile?
'Cause it's cheap. They don't make glass like they used to. Back in my day, you could run over a pair of glasses with a tank and it would utterly destroy the tank. Nowadays, I can't even pour 2 drops of water into a glass without it exploding into 3 billion pieces. And no, that's not an exaggeration, dopey.
This is due to the brittle, crystalline structure of glass, which doesn't allow it to bend or dent. This happens because the tetrahedral crystals that compose the glass are not regular and repeating. This means it cannot bend, and if enough force is applied, it will shatter. This is why glass shatters when it gets hot, because it doesn't have the ability to expand very well. NarwhalsAman44 asks, why do electric screens randomly dim and brighten?
That's the phone's way of saying, hey idiot, stop using me so much. Go outside and interact with your friends. But of course, nobody pays any attention. Some people are just way too addicted to their feed.
Hey, I am talking to my friends, you butt stain.
Yeah, well, when I was your age, your friends had to actually be there.
And when was that? 3 billion years ago?
Oh, that was a good rip. I'm genuinely hurt. Damn.
This is an automatic energy-saving mechanism designed to limit power consumption in portable devices like smartphones and laptops. The iPhone, for example, also adjusts the brightness depending on the light around you. It goes brighter when out in the sun to counteract the glare, and dim when in low light conditions. This video is not sponsored by iPhone. Milca Cebujano asks, what is the biggest star ever recorded?
I think the major problem with this question is that when you look up, they're all the same size. I guess some of them are kinda a little bigger than others. It's like comparing ants though. Man, which grain of sand on the beach is the biggest grain ever? Yeah, I'm sorry, I don't care.
UI Scuti is currently recognized as the biggest star. German astronomers discovered it in 1860, but the true size was not known until 2012 when it was observed through the Very Large Telescope in the Atacama Desert, Chile. It is between 1,054,378,000 to 1,321,540,000 miles in radius, which is 1,700 times the radius of the sun.
Hey guys, what is it? What do you want?
What?
What are you talking about?
You wanted to talk to me, right? Said something about the biggest star ever.
Come on! Not you, you dingus!
Huh?
He thinks biggest star means him.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Hey, what can I say? I'm fantastic.
Jacket the Rooster asks, why are eagle, falcon, hawk, and vulture females larger than males?
That's just a myth. Nobody can tell the difference between a male or female bird. Visibly, they look exactly the same. Angry eyes, hook face. You haven't got much to work with.
You saying Melissa looks like a guy?
Her? She's got bird disease. It's different. If she spent more time exercising and less time swooping on people rambling about Latin, she'd be bigger than all of us.
What are you talking about? Melissa's ripped. She plays tons of sports. Her body is tight. It's just hidden under her feathers.
Well, no, I... Wait, how do you know what a buddy looks like?
Girls know things that boys don't. The best theory suggests that it has to do with the females taking care of the nest, called reverse sexual size dimorphism. The female spends more time building the nest and then incubating the egg, and therefore must keep the eggs warm and protected. So it would make sense that she would be larger to defend herself. The male needs to be lean to catch prey efficiently. Clark Guild asks, why do we only have 5 senses? Are there other senses that exist? Or others that we don't know about that we may have?
You know when you're at the beach and you get sand stuck between your toes and you try and brush it off, but it just makes more sand stick in there and you realize you're literally surrounded by sand and there's no escape, so you feel frustrated, depressed, and sunburned? I have no idea if that's another sense. It's just been bothering me, so I thought I should tell you.
Well, I love the beach.
Good for you.
You should just give it a chance.
No thanks.
Don't be such a pooper.
Bye.
Senses are a way for our body to register various physical phenomena and for our brain to process them. In fact, we have more than 5 senses, although the exact amount cannot be agreed upon. Some additional senses that have been confirmed are pressure, itch, balance, temperature, hunger, pain, and thirst. Ah, it's so nice to relax.
Whoa, guys, check this out! Biggest grain of sand I've ever seen in my life!
Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a cool one!